Please stand to me as you open up the word of God. Oh, dear and heavenly Father, we thank you for the ability to come here this afternoon for an occasion like this. We pray your blessing over this afternoon's proceedings, dear Lord. I pray that you would be with Kasem, dear God, with his vocals, be with his hands. Strengthen him, dear God, when he is weak, dear God, as he comes to deliver this recital to us this afternoon, dear God. I pray that you would be with each and every single one of us. Prepare us to receive what he has prepared for us, dear God. And I pray that everything would go according to his plan and to his design, dear God, even according to your will and to your purpose. We thank you for what you're about to do here this afternoon. And we pray that it gives you all the honor and all the praise. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
You may be seated. Like you can see. After a most difficult pregnancy, and having to be on bed rest for almost the entire 9 months, the baby inside the womb decided to give his mom a break, and after a mere 31 minutes of labor, at 12:25 p.m. on 19th April 1996, weighing in at 7 pounds 14 ounces, Kasem Junior Thompson was born, crying his lungs out as loud as he could. His mother described him as a clinging, cry baby, and according to her, 25 years later, nothing has changed. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, good evening, and welcome to Kasem Junior Recital, where hopefully he won't cry. It was at the tender age of 4 when his mom first noticed his musical talent, as he was always singing at home. And at his preschool graduation, no, he didn't cry, but instead sang the loudest of all the students. In 2009, while attending church in the valley, the drums were there, very much unattended, and one Sunday, Kasem just sat on them and played. Sometime later, a bass guitar was purchased. Once again, left unattended. And this too, he just decided to play one Sunday. It's as if the instruments were calling his name. It was also in 2009 that Kasem joined the Albina Lake Lodge Conference School Concert Band at the directorship of Mr. Lamont's School, and was introduced to the trombone. He also joined the steel orchestra under the direction of Mr. Michael Dumber Martin and played double tenor there. He was also a member of the ALACS school choir under the directorship of Mr. Anthony Jacobs. In 2010, when Ms. Ashia D'Souza joined the staff at the ALACS, she took on Mr. Pearson and, in her words, said to him, "You look like somebody who could be pushed." And with that, he joined Tranquility School of Music, where Mr. Souza was the teacher, and private music classes in the steel pan began. Later that year, Mr. Souza, through a network, enrolled him into the summer music camp at UVI, and his dear Kasem met Professor Benzen. In Kasem's words, Professor Benzen really prepared him for the music world, and it was then he was formally taught the rudiments of music. In 2013, while at church, Mount Egan Central Baptist, the pianist was absent, and that was the beginning of him playing the piano, as once again, an instrument called his name, and he responded. Some of Kasem's accomplishments to date. In 2018, Kasem performed here, played at the winner's recital for the American Prodigy Competition, where they placed second in the woodwinds and brass section. Later in 2018, he joined St. Thomas and began studies with Bachelor of Arts in Music at the University of the Virgin Islands. became the director of the Harmonic Voices, a small group of singers founded in the UBI choir. He was toured the musical club, now known as Musicians on the Rise, of which he's president. He's also the bass and piano player of the Shutdown Band in St. Thomas. In Angola, Kasem is the co-founder of Steel Brass and Blues, music director of Bear Music, assistant choir director of the Angola National Choir with responsibility for the male chorus and youth choir. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please join me in welcoming first the Gordon Richardson, who is a accompanist for today's recital, the Gordon. And to the young man who will bring us much musical ear candy, Mr. Kasem Thompson.
The first piece that I'll be playing is called Panis Angelicus, composed by the Belgian-born French composer César Franck. Panis Angelicus translates to English as Bread of Angels, and it was originally written for tenor voice with organ accompaniment and transcribed for trombone by Henry Simpson. Enjoy.
Thank you.
The next piece is called Sonata in G minor by the Baroque composer from Italy, Benedetto Marcello. It comprises of four works. It was originally written for cello with basso continuo. Today we're going to be performing the fourth movement.
Thank you.
The next piece was composed by the classical composer George Frederick Handel. It's entitled Adagio Cantabile, originally composed for violin with piano accompaniment.
Thank you. Good evening again, and it is time for intermission. This intermission takes a slightly different format. We have been playing a game, so get your phones out. Take your phones out, you're playing a game. Rule number one, Mr. Blackpool is not participating in the game. The game is only for persons physically present. Not for online viewers, as there will be prizes at the end of the game for persons doing extremely well in the quiz. So on your phones, you're going to go to joinmyquiz.com. Joinmyquiz.com. Let me know when you have it. You have 30 seconds to answer each question, and do answer as quickly as you can, because this is what I call accurate answers. It's accurate answers of timely manner as well.
So we can see persons who are on. When everybody's on, please let me know. We won't see your scores on this one. You ready? No? What year was the steel pan invented? 1929, 1939, 1940. 2-1. You can have background noise, you know. Background music. And on. That's it? Next question. 3-2-1. Caribbean music comes from a complex mix of influences, of the Nistigo, which is not one of them, African cultures, European colonialism, Pacific cultures, unique characteristics of the islands.
Thank you.
time is almost up. So, that's it. One last question. The sackbut is an ancestor of the modern trombone, trumpet, tuba, or French horn. There's a bonus question. 3, 2, 1. Which famous female artist is Nicholas Branco worked with? Aretha Franklin, Didi Bridgewater, Roberta Flack, and Jake Scott. Those of you who don't know Nicholas Branco, he was up for a Grammy Award some years ago at the Broadway Sisters. The winner will be announced at the end of the recital.
The opening piece that we'll be coming back with is called Tumarai by the composer from the Romantic era, Robert Schumann. It was originally composed for piano and it is part of a work called Scenes from Childhood. Tumarai is translated into English to mean dreaming. And it's supposed to depict someone, well, a child going through dreamland before they come back to reality.
Thank you. The next piece is called Beautiful Dreamer by Stephen Foster, an American composer from the Romantic era. The song is about a beautiful dreamer who is oblivious to worldly cares, and hypothetically, he may be even dead, which is one of the themes that drives Stephen Foster's compositions. The nature of the piece has a folk-like character that evokes a calm and quiet mood. And I know a few of you may be aware of my vocal propensities behind the illustrious Viacana, but my niche is really in opera and choral works, which is one of the things that my professor and private instructor in St. Thomas is pushing me to embrace more and more.
Of the rude world heard in the day, lulled by the moonlight, have all passed away. Beautiful dreamer, queen on my song, list while I woo thee with soft melody. Gone are the cares of life's busy throng. Beautiful dreamer, awake unto me. Beautiful dreamer, awake unto me. Beautiful dreamer out in the sea, mermaids are chanting the while o'erly. Over the streamlet vapors are borne, waiting to fade at the bright coming morn. Beautiful dreamer, beam on my heart, e'en as the morn on the streamlet and sea. Then will all clouds of sorrow depart. Beautiful dreamer, awake unto me. Beautiful dreamer, awake unto me.
The final piece is Concerto for Trombone, second movement, composed by the late Baroque interclassical composer George C. Blankenship. He would have been a contemporary of Joseph Haydn and Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. At that time, in the 18th century, works for trombone were really rare. This would have been one of the first concertos that was written for the trombone, as a lot of the pieces were written for string quartet, harpsichord, organ, cello, and other instruments of that time.
Thank you.
in any vote of thanks, we always begin by giving God praises. As if he hadn't woken us up this morning, kept us through this day, we would not have been here, at least not physically, at this recital. So to God, thank you. To Kasem Thompson, thank you for the opening prayer. To the pastor and members of First Baptist Church, thank you for the use of the chapel. To the body, which is pastor of Carmen's Vision Studio. Your fingers, I swear, have their own brain, as they're capable of expressing every musical idea once you sit on the piano. Know how much talent you have tomorrow. Thank you. My brother Juan, my son Nicholas, and my other adopted son Amani for live streaming. Thank you. Thank you for the program designs and prize designs. We should stand here, Nelson Connor, for the printing of the programs. Thank you, our sponsors, Flow, Tasters, and Eaten Out. Thank you as well. To Dr. Leroy Trotman, Kasem's trombone tutor. Mr. Gilchrist Sproul, his vocal instructor. And the chair, Dion Parsons, and the musical faculty at UVI. Thank you. To our beautiful ushers who have been always with us, thank you. Via music, for the use of the PA system, their hard work, thank you. Caliban Vantipool of Limitless Shots, thank you for capturing the moments. And to you, our audience, thank you for your continued support. Thank you for being an important part of my story. And I leave with you these words from Thomas Jefferson. Whenever you want to do a thing, though it can never be known but to yourself, ask yourself, how would you act were all the world looking at you and act accordingly? But I will go further and say, whenever you want to do a thing, though it can never be known but to yourself, ask yourself, how would you act when God is looking at you and act upon you? Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. And we begin our prize giving ceremony. But before that, I need to know if there is a Terence? Thank you. Okay. Third prize, which is a voucher, $20 from Eating Out, goes to Tiandra. Ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of our most wonderful evening. Can we just stand and repeat the grace? The grace of our Lord. Thank you for coming.